to Sunnyvale Vice Mayor Nancy Smith.
Thank you, Tara, and thank you everybody for the honor of speaking with you today. I'm going to set my timer so I don't go over. And I am really proud of this class. I've been able to join you for a couple of sessions and really enjoyed it and gotten to know some of you a little bit. I wanted to say that Tara shared with me what your homework was for today. It is your personal reflection and vision assignment. And I remember when I took leadership at Sunnyvale, how tough that was for me. And there were a lot of hard questions on it. And I just want to speak to how I do not want it to be your last time that you're contemplating these questions. And so in solidarity with you and the class, I'm going to give my little presentation about how I would answer the questions today. So I think the first one, and I may be stealing a little bit of thunder, apologies for that, but I wanted to answer the question about what brought me here. So I'm speaking before you today, and this is going to sound a little trite and expected, but it's because of Leadership Sunnyvale that I am here today. I remember when I first joined, I was the class of 99, and David Rosbrink was on the committee to select the participants. And we had to fill out a questionnaire, and one of the questions was, what is the first time you recall being a leader? And that one really threw me for a loop, because I didn't really see myself as a leader. I was very much involved with nonprofit work, and I was interested in switching over to legislating things, because I thought that was more impactful. And so I thought really hard about it, and I have I'll share with you what I came up with. I was on a board of a food pantry in Dallas, Texas. And we had an incident where one of the people who got food got really angry with his girlfriend and started threatening her because she didn't get enough food from the food pantry. And the volunteers got rather upset and wanted to have an armed policeman at the food pantry. And at the time, I just felt that really went against my personal values and the values that what we tried to accomplish at the food pantry. Our motto was to err on the side of grace, and I just didn't feel it was very a good message for people coming in to get food to also have an armed off-duty policeman there. So I went on a mission to change the policy on the board, and I did. So that was the first time that I really felt that I had exhibited leadership skills and stepped up to the plate and put myself out there. And so I shared that story with David Vosbrink and whoever else interviewed me. I think it was at the West Conference, or the Council Conference Room. And I remember just feeling very, it's something that was so emotionally touching to me to share my first leadership story with the Leadership Sunnyvale interview team. And I was selected, and I just felt really excited about that. And so the next question is, what are you called to do? So I answered two of the questions there. So what are you called to do? So since that time, I've been called to work with people so they can be effective and engaged citizens. I took the lessons I learned and carried them forward. And so during my time in office, I've worked with residents and students and community groups, up-and-coming women leaders, and business owners to help articulate their problem statements and research the things they care about, research solutions that might work here in Sunnyvale, and then present those ideas to the city council so the city council and staff can take action on what really matters to people of Sunnyvale. And it has been, in my observation, it's been a great benefit to the city of Sunnyvale to have such an invigorated cadre of empowered and active citizens. And so I want to congratulate you all for joining, you know, with me in that realm of alumni of Leadership Sunnyvale. And I'll just share that recently somebody asked me, well, you know, you're so busy with the council and your work and all the things you do. What do you do for self-care? And I'm going to say that the things that I just described about helping people pursue what they care about is that a young man this week wrote a letter advocating about, oh, is that the timer?
No, it's me. Okay. I'm sorry.
Advocating
isn't doing anything
for not cutting funding to senior adult daycare centers. And so he wrote a letter to Anthony Rendon, the Speaker of the Assembly. And it just so happened I was able to talk to Anthony Rendon this week about his letter. And Anthony was very impressed that a young man from Sunnyvale isn't writing about things that will impact him directly, but about an altruistic thing that impacts the lives of other people. And I shared it with people on the governor's aging master plan for aging working group. And they sent this young man an email to let the governor know his views. And so I'm thinking that today, maybe the governor is reading this advocacy statement from a young man from Sunnyvale, speaking up for seniors. So to me, that's very invigorating. And I really love that kind of work. And that's how I do my self-care. And I just want to share for you, what I'm hoping for you as graduates is that when you take on the mantle of being an alumnus of Leadership Sunnyvale, that you will become, this is the mission statement that the alumni group came up with in 2007, I just looked it up. Trustees of effective community leadership is the vision for the alumni. And the mission is to enhance connections among and within the community, to inform and educate citizens of Sunnyvale about resources that are available to them for leadership, and to match resources with community leadership needs. And above all, I hope that that you will ask yourselves these questions year after year, because we need to keep refreshing how we respond to problems. And so the questions that I'll leave you with, just don't ask it this year, but ask, what can I do, what am I called to do, and what are we called to do? So that is my statement for Leadership Sunnyvale for you today. And I am just so impressed with the class, and I'm so looking forward to seeing what you do. So to wrap it all up, what I did immediately after graduating from Leadership Sunnyvale was I applied for the Housing and Community Services Commission. And there are many boards and commissions in Sunnyvale that have vacancies right now. We are in an election year, so I know that some of you have heard my talks on campaigning, so maybe that's something to consider kind of rather awkwardly, you know, given the situation with the races this year. But I am very much looking forward to seeing you in the community, and congratulations, and back to you, Tara.